So there I was, minding my own business on a Monday morning, getting ready to come out and demo yet another guitar pedal or any number of other things that are patiently waiting here, when our great benefactor Cliff drops yet another firmware update for the Mighty Axe FX 3, and this time he's included my very favourite amplifier, which is the HIWATT DR103. I believe Cliff owns a real bona fide 70s one, and I've got a good HIWATT here that I can compare to. It's not a 70s one, but it's a good custom 50 SA212. I know what a good one sounds like. These sound probably better. So that's given me great cause to write yet another preset that I'm sharing with you, and it's got 8 scenes. And the firmware update exhibits significant improvements all over, I think, in these amp models. They're just amazing. So, firstly, this is a Bitzer Numcaster, I call it, put together by myself and Ray Carlton with Ben Bailey at JJ's Guitar Pickups. These are called the V12 set, and they're based on David Gilmour's Black Strat set. This is a pretty hot single coil, and these are period correct neck and middle pickups. Scene one, and this is going to be a long video because there's a bit of an explanation happening here. Scene one features the high power jumped. So it sounds like this. The classic tone. The reverb I'm using is the studio reverb, and just, you know, not much level really, just a little bit to give it a bit of room. The cabs are a mixture of the legacy factory cabs. So you've got the Star Found and the HIWATT mix and the High Power mix. Slightly panned and, you know, a few levels. They sound balanced to my ears. You can get in there and muck with them and do what you need as well. So that's scene one, okay? We've got, you know, not much wound up here in input world and master volumes at 6 where it's it is by default just a little less bass. Scene two is jumped up, the same amp in a different channel but with the input drive. Now how good is that? I've never heard that sound before in previous firmware. I'm pretty sure that I look for it, but man, that is great. So that's why it's called jumped up. Scene three is just the normal channel, the normal input of the 103. Quite dark, compressed sounding, and if you're playing it loud, it's a crushing clean tone. Makes an insanely great pedal platform, and we'll have a look at some drives in a minute. Scene four is the brilliant channel. Has slightly more output, which I've supplemented by driving the input drive even harder. It's just got that little bit of breakup on the edge there. Scene five kicks things into overgear. So I've taken the jumped up channel and I've thrown in front of it the old super overdrive with the dials like so, and it's big. We'll be right back. The delay is a digital stereo delay. I call it DG delay A. It's a bit like a David Gilmour kind of delay. And, you know, really, let's make no illusions here. That's what these sounds are based on, that kind of thing. The reverb is the Asylum Hall reverb with, you know, quite a bit mixed in. But that super overdrive really loves the front end of the high power. Yeah. So, scene six brings in the boxer crunch, or the crunch box, with the dials like so, and the amp platform that I've used for it is the high power jumped, which is channel A, and it sounds like this. A lot more thwack, but tight thwack in the bottom end. So compared to the SD1 solo scene, it's such good fun. I hope you enjoy this as much as I've enjoyed writing it. Scene 7, Muftum, because it's got the pie fuzz in front of it, but I've also put a fairly slow script 90 phaser in there, and the platform is the normal channel of the HIWATT. Now that phaser may be too much for some, so just turn it off. And of course, if you want to, you can experiment, you know, by swapping the amp channel. Which will yield significantly different results. And then scene 8, the final scene is just, you know, something gentle with a bit of rotary in it. And the rotary's got my standard rotary block in it that moves itself. Let's go back to number one for a moment, the jumped channel, because I want to show you this flange that I've popped in here. Now, if I go to channel B, the standard flanger for or electric mistress flanger, it sounds like this. But I've popped one in channel A, which reverses a little bit. So there's not that much difference, but the difference is that I've reversed the phase in the left channel, which gives you that kind of stereo imaging, as opposed to channel B. Now, if we throw, say, some delay in there and we put a drive in there as well, we'll use the super overdrive. So there's mine, and here's the standard one. It's just a little thing, but it lets you decide, you know, you have a choice. You can try mine, see what you think. And if you don't like it, you can turn it off. Phaser. Channel A is the script 90, and channel B is the... is the vibe. You'll also find the compressor here, which is the good old Dynacomp compressor. So for instance, if you're using the Muftum, the Pi-Fuzz loves a compressor up the front of it if you're soloing away. There it is, fellas, ladies and fellas, ladies and gents. The Berg's High Power Firmware 16 Cliff. Thank you so much. Bye.